impacts us, particularly the transgender community, right now. Thank you. We also celebrate the pivotal role that Miss Vicky plays in shaping the film and her own story of resilience. And we hope that this film is going to create an opportunity for a wide conversation across many audiences so people understand Marsha and our community's history and the violence we're currently facing. So, please, help me welcome to the stage the cast and crew of The Death and Life of Marsha P. Johnson. It's a lot of folks, so come on all up.
Cruz. I come from the island Borinque. If you don't know where it is, it's now called Puerto Rico.
That was a good shout
out. I have to tell you, it's a compelling story. This flag, the American flag. My father fought in World War II and saw Korean action. He saw atrocities and he told me about that. When he passed away in 1982, this flag was draped over his coffin. When everything was over, my mother gathered all 10 of us together. And she told us that my father wanted me to have this flag because I would need it the most. So I cherish it, and I feel it protects me. Unfortunately, because of these political times, it's kind of hard. I would like to thank, first of all, the donors of this agency for what they do. I'm also a survivor of more crimes than you can imagine. It was one of these crimes that set me forth to call Anti-Violence Project at 1:30 in the morning. The person who answered that phone was Robin Nichols, who's a social worker in the Pasco District in San Francisco. I will never forget her. What I received when I made that call was compassion, humanity, and guidance. I would like to thank also Christine Quinn for hiring me, who changed my life. I would like to thank the volunteers who I feel are the backbone of this agency, and all they do. I would like to thank Kat for your supervision. I learned a lot from you. Is Sharon here? Where is she? Sharon, where are you? Sharon, I've been pardoned by Vice President Joe Biden for taking that half roll of toilet paper from the White House. He told me I could have taken the whole roll because the president administrator or administration is throwing paper towels to my island of Puerto Rico. My co-workers, I have a little bit of all of you in here, past and present. Thank you, darling. I won't forget anybody. I want to thank also Sylvia and Marsha. When Sylvia was dying, I would go to St. Vincent's Hospital and sit with her. Because whenever I needed her to place somebody in shelter, she never turned me down. She also sat me down the day before she passed away. She didn't want to eat. She said, I need to talk to you. I said, okay, Sylvia. She says, try. Please try to keep our community together because we can be our own worst enemy. And it's true. I made her that promise and I will keep it. Well, I want to get this right. We make a difference. And in 2020, we're going to make a difference. I want to get this perfectly right. It's going to be a huge difference. I want to thank all of you for being so generous and keeping that compassion, that humanity, and that guidance alive by your donation. Thank you so very much. I also want to dedicate this award to those who are fighting, those men and women who are fighting and keeping this country what it is. America the beautiful. Thank you.
You know, advice started over 20 years ago as a skateboard magazine by two guys in Montreal. The only rule that they really had was, let's make the best content for our audience. At the time, it was young men who were just on a skateboard and probably high. And over the last 20 years, it's grown to be one of the largest youth media brands in the world. And one of the things that we've recognized over that time is actually that a majority of our audience does not identify as heterosexual, much like the world at large. And on top of that, one of the things that we know is since the 2016 election, 25% of LGBTQ youth have actually experienced an increase in feeling discrimination on a day-to-day basis. So we had to look really at ourselves and at our different platforms and say, what kind of responsibility do we have to our audience who come to us to see themselves, to find solace, to find entertainment, to get the news? And that's an incredible amount of responsibility. And what can we actually create within that that actually can start change? So one of the things that we've always been committed to is we know that the first step to create change is to bear witness. And one of the things that we feel is the most important is we go to a place, we press record, we come back, and we put it out. We're not in the game of fake news or in the basis of questioning what is a fact, but we believe in still creating the best content for our audience. And you know, we have folks who are here in the front tonight who are from all of the platforms that were just mentioned who really make the content that's being talked about. And we know that in order to create change for young people who are growing up in a whole new set of crises, they have to have the opportunity to be able to see themselves and be represented in more than a one-dimensional way. When we started to make Vacation, we were like, okay, is this an LGBTQ show? Is it a travel show? What is it? Nothing needs to be siloed. Our lives are not one-dimensional, and neither should our content, and neither should be how we are represented on a day-to-day basis. So I just really want to thank this project and this organization for recognizing something that is really a joy for us to do on a day-to-day basis, and we're just really happy to be here and to continue this work. So thank you.
But we are here to celebrate, as I started out. Even though the impact of all of these events are hitting us in so many different ways, we're feeling it. And I was going to ask tonight for a moment of silence, and obviously that's not going to work for this one. But you know, I wasn't really feeling silence anyway, because we need... No. That's okay. Because we're going to do something else. Instead of sharing a moment of silence, I actually want us to make some noise. I'm going to raise our voices as loudly as possible in a shout for freedom, for safety. Or you can just raise your voice to shout. Ready? Go! I want to hear you.